In 1955 and 1958, Baba came with all the Sahawasis that had come from all over India just to show them his last resting place in 1955 and 1958 Sahawas. And he led all the people, he was in front, and all other people, all the lovers that had come from various parts of India, they were being led. And Baba came and entered the Samadhi, the would-be Samadhi in 55 and 58. And then when we were entering the Samadhi, Baba said, when you go inside and pay your respects to my Samadhi, remember, make a vow, resolve that you will make everyone happy, even at the cost of your happiness. Make this resolve while you are inside the Samadhi and you are paying your respects to the Samadhi. Resolve that you will try to make everyone happy, even at the cost of your happiness, even if you have to suffer for that. Mansari, have you got to say anything?
When in 20s, Baba in that crypt sat in for seclusion, for his universal work. He was inside 6 months. Nobody was allowed inside and he didn't come out. And for whole 6 months, he partook only 5 or 6 cups of coffee every day. And he has appointed one small boy, about 10, 11 of age, to bring that coffee from down below. And sometimes he found out that it was only 3 or 4 cups for him. So after 6 months, he just asked the boy, what had happened to the coffee? If you tell me the truth, I will forgive you. Then the boy said that whenever I got the whim, I used to drink it to my heart's content. And then he showed the tree under which he used to sit and drink. Then Baba forgave him. And some of the mandali become angry, but he said that why should you be angry? As always, you all have Bhai Prasads. Now this time, during these 6 months, I had his Prasad. So what makes difference? Now that is his compassion and the sense of humor. Now what you see, the tomb now, at the left side of it, there was a whole big stages, one big stage there. Yeah. And on that side, on it, there were 5 rooms for meditation. Very few had that opportunity by Baba's order to sit in and meditate according to his order. Baba sat on that platform with the boys, Premashram boys, and he discoursed and gave lectures through the board, of course. He then played games with them, cricket, marbles, cycling, and everything. Now you say, Nana.
Yes, during this period, when the rooms were there, at that time, one's leader, who was observing silence by Baba's orders, he was made to sit in one of the rooms. And he was taking only milk during that period, and he was on complete silence. And he was not to come out of the room. The room was being locked from outside by someone, and he was to remain in the room continuously for a long period. It so happened that during that period when he was locked from outside and sitting in the room, and as per Baba's instructions and silently remembering Baba, he saw all of a sudden a big cobra entering the room, and it came up and went on the ceiling of the room. The room was so short that he could not even stand up. It was so so the cobra went up, and he looked at the cobra, and they were facing each other. Because he was silent, he couldn't call anyone. He couldn't do anything, and no one was there to respond to him at that time. It was night time. So he was just facing, the cobra was facing him, and he was facing the, and he was actually face to face with death. And he didn't know what to do. And so he was remembering Baba, 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 what? He couldn't do anything, no shouting, nothing of that, because he was on silence. And he faced the cobra like that for the whole night. The cobra looking at him, and he looking at the cobra. And he was, and he at that time, he experienced what is death. Because he was facing death actually. And he couldn't do anything. Then after some time in the morning, the cobra quietly left the room and he went away. But he didn't bite him. That was the thing, you see. He was saved completely by Baba. But he was facing him for quite a long number of hours, you see. And he was actually face to face with death. So then, when later on he came out and he told this incident to Baba, Baba said, "Now you know what is death." So Mansari, have you got to say anything? So Jai Baba to all those. Hearty Jai Baba to all those who are listening.
Dhanakar and Mansari. This is a question I think that this is a question that a lot of people may have asked themselves, and would like to know from you, since you both live here. Now, Nanaka, you are Baba's watchman here at the tomb,
yes,
continuously.
The caretaker.
And Mansari, you've been here for about 20 years, too.
33 years.
Oh.
don't tell that away my pride.
Yeah, let Mansari speak in also. Could you tell us a story of what Baba was doing at the time when he would visit the tomb himself, because this was built sometime before Baba dropped his body?
Sometime in 1938.
Yes, would you tell us about that?
It has been built in 1938, the thorough built. Before, there were only all round tatas, that means the mat walls all round. And on the top, not so high, but little bit lower, there was tin roof. And the crypt was just ready beforehand. And in 1920s, Baba sat in for seclusion, what I told before. And in 1938, it has been built properly with stone walls and all these signs.
Now we are making a move from the right side, moving around the samadhi.
Could you tell us a little?
And from, as you see from outside, you see there are symbols of religion, you see. On one side, there is the temple representing Hindu religion. Then on the other side, there is the mosque. And here you see the symbol of Agari, a fire temple, you see. And the significance of the fire temple, Mansari will tell you.
It is said, Baba has said, that it is fire is not only fire. It says that 24 hours in your heart, the fire of the love for God should be burned all the time, 24 hours, shouldn't be extinguished. And so that is the sign, and we had the same thing in our fire temple, the 24 hours, the fire in a big vessel, all the time goes on.
Baba was completely universal in his love for God through any religion. Did Baba
said that these four signs I made because all the religions God has made, and I am God. I have created the all religion, and all the religions are same to me.
Baba said that.
And Baba said, I belong to no religion, but all religions are mine. And it is I who has given all the religions, but I am above all religions. And I am the only one that all religions are approaching, you see, by different ways. I am above religion.
You've seen all people of all castes approach Baba, including the untouchables?
Yes, every religion, every caste, creed, you see. And Baba was for each and everyone, for all religions, for all castes, for all creeds. And he gave his infinite love to each and everyone, you see, whomsoever came. And there was no distinction for anyone.
Have you seen Baba with the untouchables?
Yes, he has worked with the untouchables at Lower Mehrabad when Baba was staying here, you see. He specially called the untouchable boys, and he would bath them, he would clothe them, he would even clean their latrines. This work he has done with his own hands.
Have you seen this?
No. Those who were there at that time, Padri, he has seen it. Mansari has also seen these things, you see, Baba doing.
Would you tell us about that, Mansari?
Baba took me once, when I came first, Baba took me once to the Mast Ashram and said not to touch to anyone, but he made me stood on one corner and he let me allow to see what he does. He bathed the mast and wash them, and then dry them with a towel, then clothe him, and then he just gave the food, and that's all. He just smiled at me, that, did you see? He asked me, and I said, yes.
And now you're able to tell about it because you saw it.
Yes, oh yes, that is the thing that I am fortunate. And about going back to the religion, just it reminds me that once Sai Baba was asked which caste he was. And he said, I belong to no caste. My own caste is Parvardigar. And so we think and we are sure that Baba himself is Parvardigar. So there is no caste with Baba.
In the same way, Baba has also said that I belong to no religion. All religions are mine. And if at all you want to know my religion, I am the ancient one. That is my religion. I am the ancient one.
I am the ancient one. Did Baba ever play any games or fly kites or anything like that out here, or marbles in this area?
Yes, I have seen that. I have that luck to see him flying kites and lighting firecrackers. He used to just light a firecracker, and as soon as the spur of the moment it break, he just used to run. And we just used to shout in happiness.
Baba used to light the firecrackers himself, huh?
Yes, and just like that.
Mansari, did you help Baba with the flying of the kites?
We in turn helped Baba losing the thread of the kite, holding our the bobbin in our hands, turn by turn. We just undid it, and Baba has to just let Kai fly, go up and up and up. And he enjoyed it. He's still flying, I'm sure. The whole universe is his kite.
See, Nanakir, I understand that you played marbles with Baba. Would you tell us about that?
Yes. Once I had the occasion to play marbles with Baba. It was at Eluru in Andhra tour, you see. Baba said, we will play marbles. And so he started. And every time he would hit. Then one by one we got the turns to play, and some of us could hit and some of us could not hit. But Baba always hit and he never missed. He said, I am the one who never misses, like Ram, you see, like his arrow, you see, which is always sure to reach the target, you see. I never miss my mark. And so always he won.
Did he have a lot of people playing marbles?
Yes, lot of people. About 20, 30 people were there, you see. Lovers, you see, who participated. And Baba was the last to win, you see. Because everyone else, you see, dropped. As soon as you miss the mark, then you are out, like that.
So Baba,
and the symbols also, as you see that, on this side there is a cross. Depicting the crucifixion of Christ. Baba said, you could see his crucifixion from outside, but I am being crucified every second, every moment of my life. And that is how, you see, I have to work for the whole humanity. But you can't see my crucifixion. It is internal. Ansari, you have to say anything about
you
this?
You say about the Kerem. Symbols.
And then on this side, there is the mosque, symbol of mosque, masjid. Mohammedans, they pray to Allah in this mosque, you see. So representing the Muslims. And it has got a crescent, you see, on the top, you see, because they are the worshippers of Moon.
Did Baba ever speak anything about Mohammed?
Yes, he said, you see, I was Mohammed and I have come again as Meher Baba. It is after 1400 years that I have come. And there is one incident that happened actually when Baba's body was lying here, and when he was giving the last darshan after dropping the body, his body was kept here for 8 days continuously, kept open for darshan. When on the 8th day it was interned, you see. On 31st, you see, the body was brought. On 7th February, the body was interned. So during that period, thousands of lovers came from all over India, even from foreign countries, and they were paying their last respects to the beloved body of their avatar. And at this time, one thing happened, you see, showing that how he's connected. He is the same one. As he said, you see, I was Muhammad when I came 1400 years back. So when he was giving this darshan during the 7 days period, at that time, what happened? Makkah, where they go for Hajj, the Muslims go for Hajj, and there is a stone which is called Kaaba, on which they pay their respects, they kiss the stone, and everyone who goes for Hajj, he that is the place where they pay their respects to Muhammad. So during this period of 7 days, it so happened that there was, on the very first day when Baba's body was brought here, there was huge rain, continuous rain for nearly 24 hours on 30th January, and the whole place was completely covered with water, and for 7 days none could approach the Kaaba.
Where Muhammad is now buried.
Yes, that is the Kaaba, you see, Makkah, where all Muslims go to pay respect to Muhammad, you see. So that Kaaba was under water for 7 days, which has never happened before this. And that is a desert, actually. There is very little rainfall. But at that time, there was so much rain that the whole Kaaba was under water, and that too continuously for 8 days. No one could approach the Kaaba. And on 7th February, he was interned here at Mehrabad. From that time onwards, you see, then it was cleared of all the water, and then people could go and have the darshan. So that shows the deep connection between Muhammad and Baba.
Were
and
that
this
Baba
thing,
famous?
This
it has been printed in papers, because it's never happened like that. Because in Arabia, how you get so much rain? And connected with this, I have read some Baba said, when he said, I don't know, but I have read some paper, typed paper, And Baba said that Muhammad's greatness is not in Kaaba, it is in Karbala, because for love's sake there has been given so many sacrifices, and my Karbala is Mehrabad, where so many sacrifices for love for me will be given.
Nanakar, what else can you tell us?
I have played other games also with Baba, apart from marbles. Once when Baba was at Ganesh Khind, you see, and he asked me, do you know Karam? I said, yes. I was once a champion in that game. Then Baba said, you will be my partner, because whenever Baba used to play games, he would take as his partner the best one among those who were present. So I, being a champion once in my college days, so he said, you will be my partner. And so we started playing, Baba on my side and two others. Baba's brother Jal was there and someone else, Bahu was there, Bahu Kalchuri. So they two on one side and Baba and myself on one side. And within two turns, we cleared the whole board and we won the game. So Baba said, you see, whenever I play, I also never miss. As you are a champion, I am also a champion. And at that time I found, you see, because I was playing after a very long period, but Baba never missed.
Did Baba ever play games with you, Mansari? Did Baba ever play games with you or the women?
Yes, the card, but he never let us win.
And then you had to rub the ball?
No. That rule started in Guru Prasad, not with us.
How did he prevent you from winning?
Because he is the winner all the time.
And when Baba was at Guru Prasad, he often used to play the game of La Risk, and with 4 persons, with 10 persons, with 20 persons, any number of persons could participate. And all those who lost, they had to rub their nose before Baba, you see. All those who... Yes, on the carpet. And Baba said, you see, what a great fortune you have got, you see. No one is allowed to bow down to me, but you are allowed to rub your noses, that means you are bowing down to me. So you are not the losers, you are actually the winners. So those who lose, they win actually.
And the winners lose.
And by rubbing the nose, you are repenting, and all your impressed samskaras, you see, they are wiped out, you see. So that was the opportunity given to all those, you see, who were near Baba, you see. Just in fun, you see, they were given the great privilege of wiping out their samskaras, you see, just by rubbing their noses before Baba and bowing down to him, you see, which was never allowed by Baba. Rarely allowed anyone to bow down to him. That thing also, we had the privilege, you see, while playing the game with Baba, and we would sit very close to Baba at that time.
I remember one time in Guru Prasad that the game was being played, and I didn't understand at all how this game worked. But I was playing it because everyone was around Baba and they were doing it. So someone was showing me, I think it was Francis, and every other person lost. So we were all rubbing our noses on the carpet, and then every once in a while every other person would win. And until this day I never understand how that game was played.
Yes, and the way in which the game was being played, you see, that was also unique. It was above all rules, you see. No rules were observed, you see. Where people were shouting, saying one thing, another. Everyone was shouting and no one knew what was going on. And we didn't...
You asked about the same,
yes.
As I have heard that Baba used to ask for the card which he wanted to win, and they all have to give him, and then he win the race. He won the game, and then all have to rub the nose.
So, and every time Baba would win, and even if he lost, you see, he was always exempt from rubbing. All others had to rub. All those who are on Baba's side, they had to come, but Baba won't give up. He was the only exception.
Even with checkers, did you ever play?
Yes, I played checkers, but I was a Howrah Bridge player. That means I didn't know how to play. So within no time, you see, I was off.
Were you playing checkers with Baba or with one of the men?
No, with Baba. With Baba also I played.
Oh yes.
Yes, I played with Baba. And Baba said, "You are just a Howrah Bridge. That means you don't know how to play the game. One who doesn't know anything, you see, in the game, you see." And so I would lose very. Yeah, I would lose very, very easily.
Now it's time for lunch, and Nana is to leave. But still, our Arvind just tells us to say something, so we have to say something. We will tell you the stories. Now let's go. Shall I finish this story what I started yesterday? Or I start
now.
Go ahead. Nanaji, did Baba ever teased you?
Yes. Baba, sometimes you see, he would ask, you see, why your name? Why you are called Nana? What is the meaning of Nana? I said, Baba, I can't say. No, there must be some meaning. It means in our language, you see, the grandfather, the grand uncle. So what is the meaning of Nana? I means Nana means nothing and nothing. Nothing into nothing. That is Nana. You know the Nana Peshwe. He was a very intelligent man. Are you like that? I said, no, I am not so intelligent.
So what other mischief did Baba do with you?
Once you see, I was on during the tour. Baba stayed in one of the rest houses where the arrangement were for his stay, and they were taking out all luggage of Baba. But Baba had given instructions to all that no one should step on the veranda of the bungalow. I didn't knew that, so just to help Arash, you see, I started taking the bags and going up the veranda and keeping them. So for a while, Baba looked at me and then he said, "What is this you are doing? Don't you know I have told everyone not to enter the veranda except Arach. Arach is to bring my luggage and no one is to come here. How is it that you are coming?" I said, "Baba, I don't know that no one is to come. And I was just trying to help Arach by bringing the luggage on the veranda." So Baba said, "But you have disobeyed me. So now I will give you the punishment." So he pinched my ear. He said, "That is the punishment. Now you go." That is how he has once pinched my ears, you see.
Finished with it?
No, I have finished.
Baba loved to tease Mansari. Once he said,
yes.
Once I had been there on 15th of November in 64. And Baba told me to come on the 19th of the same month with the bhajan party of Arangao. And on the second day, Padri had been there and Baba sent message with him to remind me about to come there with the bhajan party on the 19th. Again the very next day, that means third day, a note was sent that to remind me that, "Do you remember you have to come on the 19th? The fourth day, that means one day before going, another note came that you have to come. You remember? Do you remember? Then On the 19th, I went there. As soon as Baba saw me, he just said and signed, "Why you are here?" I didn't say a word. Again, he just gave me a not a good look and asked me why I am there. Then I told that two notes and two persons are the evidence. One person is here. If he says, that means Araj, if he says that it is not sent by him, I will go the next step out. Then Araj, on the same moment, he just said that, "Oh, Baba, you made me write a chit to remind her." And then Baba just said, and made a sign that, "Keep quiet, I want to tease her." At any moment, he just used to grab the opportunity to tease me. Now, I am deprived of that fun too. That is all. I will tell you.
Go ahead.
In the last final seclusion, you see, when Baba was doing his special work, 1968, he stayed for 3 months at Guru Prasad. Later on, he came to Mehrazad. And then, during this phase, I was called to Mehrazad to be with Baba. And during my stay there, you see, one day, what happened, that Kekobad was, all of a sudden, he fell down, you see, because of the bite of a small ant, and his leg was in fracture. And at that time, daily in the morning, Baba was doing special work with Kekobad for half an hour in the morning. And because of that accident, then Kekobad couldn't, you see, participate in this work. And then Baba said, it is a great setback to my work in seclusion, and this will postpone everything that I had to, and I had the most important work with Kekobad, but because of this accident, now I won't be it won't be possible for me to complete the work in the time fixed by me, and now I will have to do it myself alone. So from the night itself, when Baba heard that Kekobad has had the accident, his leg broken, and it won't be possible for him to sit with for the work, usual work. So next day, when Baba came in the Mandli's hall at Mehrazad, he said, "I am very much upset because of this sudden illness of Kekobad, and because of that, the timetable, my whole timetable has been upset, and the thing that I wanted to give, and my manifestation, everything has been postponed, and I'm very much upset." And after a while, Baba actually began to cry like a child. And it was a most unusual sight. For some time, he was crying like a child. And then, again, he said, you see, because of this accident of Kekobad, it has upset my whole plan, and now I will have to do it myself alone. He was participating in my work, and it was very important. But this accident of Kekobad has upset everything, and now I will have to do it myself alone, and everything, the plan will have to be changed considerably.
Mansari, you once told me that there was a snake that came into your room a long time ago, and that there was a whole story connected around that.
Yes, Edward, I would willingly tell you. On the month of August 1951, in the evening, at 8 o'clock, we were just chatting. I was chatting with Kekobad's family. I have no idea what will happen, but Then after that, I went to retire at night. Now the room in which I was staying, that was Baba's cage room. Many of you might have remembered. And I wanted to get in as usual, but something hold on. That is, I just hesitate to go get in. It was just in my mind that someone might be there. I just couldn't help. And with the help of light, I entered the room and I saw up and down. Of course, the room is not so big. Up and down and everywhere. But I couldn't find anything. Then, at last, I was so sleepy. I went in bed at 8:45 and I slept like a log. Yes, when he left for new life, Baba gave me four or five sticks, long sticks, saying that if anyone comes, you break their heads with it. I have kept all the time by the side of my bed. But then what happened? At about 11:45, I felt something cold and rubbery on my chest. I just didn't care because I feel so sleepy at that hour. I turned my side, but at that time it just came to my mind that it might be a lizard, so I got up. And I shake off that sheet which was on my body. And I wanted to turn the light on. As soon as I got down, I heard the sound, tap. And what I saw, it was a snake, it was a cobra. Again coming, on my chest. And what I felt, cool and rubbery feelings. Then he began to come up to me again and began to crawl on the bed. Then I lighted another lantern, and forgetting I have four sticks with me which Baba has given, I went to another room in the kitchen, and with the woods which has been used as fuel, I brought that, and with the help of it, I just killed it. And then it took me so much time, then at about 2:00, I just cleaned everything and I wanted to go to bed. As soon as I stepped, I sat on the bed. All of a sudden I saw Baba is sitting on my bed at feet side. I just couldn't help. I just shouted. Of course, slowly, Baba, Baba, tell me something. But just nothing, as if he doesn't want to talk to me. He just stared at the place where the snake was on my chest. I was so sleepy, but on the one hand, I wanted to see Baba more. And on the other hand, I was so sleepy. So part of the time I slept, and again it came to my mind that, oh, Baba is with me. And again I saw that Baba was there, the same session, staring on my chest where the snake was. Again I shout, Baba, I dare not touch because perhaps he might leave me. That was the fear in me. So I just kept on staring at him, sometimes sleeping, sometimes sitting. At about five, that was vision, and the snake vision disappeared. Slowly faded, began to fade at 5:00. And at 5:30, it was completely gone. And when Baba came after new life, he asked me all the accounts during about 2 years. And when I told about that snake, he said that, now are you convinced that I am with you wherever you are, all the time? And I said, of course, Baba. And if the snake comes every day, I would like if you come to on my bed every day. That is all. And he smiled and he really enjoyed.
Yes, now we are entering the Samadhi of Avatar Meher Baba, the tomb of Avatar Meher Baba. And it is here in this tomb that Baba's body is kept, the mortal body of the immortal one. Here lies the body of Avatar Meher Baba, 7 feet deep. Previously, when the crypt was prepared, you see, 30 years back, when the Samadhi was built, this tomb was built, it was 6 feet deep. But when Baba's body was brought to from Mehrazad and kept here in his room, then the lower part was dug, and now it is 7 feet deep, and it is lying on earth. So on bare earth, Baba's body was kept 7 feet down, and then with all his clothes and rose flowers.